Hello everybody, welcome to the first episode of Living Baggage Free. I'm so excited to be doing this because it's something I've always wanted to do, and I'm glad I have the opportunity to do it now. So I'm Olamide Okulate, medical doctor turned rock star, singer, songwriter, and of course entrepreneur. Before I go on, I'd like to introduce and actually appreciate my sponsors. They are Sienna Fresh Skincare and Maisha Face Mask. The thing about these brands is that I'm not just talking about them. They are brands that I have had to have used at one point or the other, and I can tell you that they give you the skin that you have always dreamed of. Okay, now Sienna Fresh comes in your carrot body wash, cream carrot souffle, which is actually my favorite, your face and body butter, your acne facial wash, and of course your natural skin toner. Then you have your Maisha Face Mask. This is produced by the Home and Personal Items Limited. The beautiful thing about this is that you do not have to go to your salon or your spa for the perfect and well-pampered facial treatment. You can just use this and you'll be surprised that you have an even greater and nicer outcome. And I'm telling you because this is something that I've used by myself. So if you haven't gotten it, I advise you to go straight to the shops and the stores that will display below, and then you can get them. Okay, so let's just go straight to what we have for today. Let me first of all say that this video blog is supposed to help you deal with negative and stressful emotions that tend to impact your life negatively. They bring down the quality of your life if not well handled. Okay, so that's why we're talking about depression today. You see, we live in a really pretentious society where everybody wants to look like they are doing well. Nobody wants to look like they are depressed. Okay, so if you're not careful, you tend to think that you're the only one, but you're not. So for example, you go to your Facebook and then you see a picture, and then this couple or this person is just like, oh, I'm doing so great. We're in the Bahamas right now, and you know, take a picture. Or, oh, we're in Dubai, and everybody, you just think everybody is doing so well. Why does it look like I'm the only one who isn't on top of his or her game? I just want to tell you that that's a lie. It's not true. Everybody just wants to look like they're doing fine, because I'm sure if I come here and appear on this video and I look all depressed and haggard, I'm sure you won't want to watch this video. You're just going to be like, what is this? Like, no. So that's why, you know, people put in their best to look like they're right, they're doing well, but it's not true. So really, what are the causes of depression? Why do people get depressed? I'm not here to lecture you. I just want to give you some tips that I have found to be useful. And I've also interacted with people and I've found that these things are useful. Studies have shown that there are two major causes, apart from the organic causes you have, like, you know, sickness, illness, mental illnesses, and of course, physical abuse and other things. Apart from all that, the two major causes are financial instability and broken relationships. Now this is easy to understand, because imagine you are the CEO of, say, a multinational, and then suddenly somebody just tells you that you are fired. You can imagine how you feel. You feel like the end has come. Or you have this relationship that you love so much, or you have this spouse or this husband that you love so much, and then he just says it is over. You understand? You're just going to feel like, where do I even start from right now? Who am I? Because this relationship has come to define me. You know, it's like you have an identity crisis. Or you go to the hospital and then your doctor gives you one very, very horrible diagnosis, and you're like, I'm done. This is it for me. You know, you've been abused, or you know, all sorts of things that, you know, people encounter daily. You know, and sometimes you just tell yourself that, you know what, I'm not going to give in. I'm not going to give up. I'm going to fight this. I'm going to win this battle. And you wake up in the morning and you're like, I'm fighting. And then before you know it, something else happens. And something else. And something else. And it begins to feel like, am I the only one? Why is it that why is it looking like everything is just against me? You know, and I'm just here to encourage you that, you see, you're not the only one. There are so many people going through these things, and I hope that this will help you. Now, one of the things I've found to be very helpful in dealing with depression is having a cause. What I mean by that is that you cannot afford to live for yourself alone. I realize that there's a healthy level of self-preservation and self-love that we should have. You should think about how your life is going to improve, you know, your relationships and all that. That is healthy to some extent. But you can take it too far by being too self-absorbed. Now, if you're going around, if you're going somewhere and you see things that are not being done right, don't walk away. Don't look away. Do you understand? If there's something you notice that this is not right, if there are children around you that are hungry, if there are homeless people around you, if there is somebody around you who looks depressed, if any, I mean, just anything, anywhere you are, there's so much you can do. Even if you don't have anything, you know, some people give excuses and say, oh, I'm barely even doing well myself, I cannot get involved with somebody else. I'm telling you that there's something you can do. There's always something you can do. You can always make a difference. It may not be much, I mean, to some people, but to you, it's a lot. Now, another thing that is also really helpful is that you do not stay in isolation. Do you understand? Don't just be by yourself. Try to develop relationships, cultivate relationships with people who are real, who have a balanced perspective on life, people who have a good and positive energy around them. Don't hang with people who are always negative or people who are pretentious, who are always trying to tell you that, oh, I have a new car and is, you know, I have a new pair of shoes and I have a, you know, they're always all about themselves and how good they are doing, and you don't need such people in your life. The third thing is to get help. Now, if you begin to get to a point where you're thinking that nobody loves you, nobody wants you, you are insignificant, and you just want to take your own life, well, I would advise that you seek medical help. Now, apart from medical help, there's also something I want to leave you with. You see, the person who made you, okay, he made you in detail, okay? He's so detailed about how he made human beings, each human being, that no two people are the same. You are not the same as anybody, and that tells me that you are not a mistake. You are not you were specifically made to be you. So he knows you. He knows everything about you because he made you like that. He made the arc of your eyebrows, your eyelashes, the color of your eyes, everything, your DNA, just special and peculiar to you. So he cares. You know, there's no sparrow, there's no bird that falls on the ground that he doesn't know about. And even the Bible says that every hair on your head has been counted, so that even when one falls off, he knows. And a hair just dropped from that person. He cares. So don't you ever feel like nobody cares about you, because God, your maker, cares. I hope this has been able to help you in one way or the other. I want to please appeal that you subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you have found this useful, I would also like to appeal that you share with your friends. So thank you so much for watching. Till I come your way again, this is Olami Day saying, leave baggage free, please. Thank you.